300,000 deaths, months of lockdowns, unmatched unemployment claims. The pandemic has taken quite a toll. The mental health crisis that has stemmed from the COVID-19 pandemic is dire. Depression and anxiety is spiking, and frontline workers are seeing conditions unlike any they've seen before. Dr. Ayman Fanous is professor and chair of psychiatry at SUNY Downstate Medical Center, and he joins me now. Doctor, thanks for joining us. I want to start with the idea of COVID fatigue. What exactly is it? And look, why are so many of us feeling it right now?
Well, I mean, if you think about it, the quarantine has deprived us of lots of things that are, you know, essential to our lives, human contact, including physical contact, social support, the change of environment that we have on a daily basis, you know, going to work, going to the grocery store, going to outdoor sports games, concerts, et cetera. We have a much restricted menu of pleasurable activities at this point. And the longer we're deprived of these things, the more exhausted we're likely to become, because these are the things that sort of energize us and rejuvenate us, and most importantly, provide mental stimulation, which is so critical to being happy. So quarantine fatigue, even though it can differ from person to person, is basically the exhaustion that's associated with this new restrictive approach to living that we've had to adopt because of COVID-19. And it's associated with a number of things. As I was mentioning earlier, we are relatively understimulated, and we know that, from many studies and many different, organisms that understimulation can cause tenseness, irritability, anxiety, et cetera. So also associated with the quarantine fatigue, we have eating and sleeping changes. Certainly in my case, and in the case of many others that I've spoken to, we have these back-to-back Zoom meetings, and sometimes 4 or 5 in the afternoon, you realize that you haven't had anything to eat. Mm. And we also have a decreased motivation and productivity, because of the fatigue, because of the anxiety as well. And furthermore, there are spikes in interpersonal conflict relating to this, there's social withdrawal, et cetera. So it's a whole constellation of things. And the longer the quarantining goes on, especially compounded with the sort of uncertainty of how long it's going to go on, this fatigue, will get more and more severe.
What about when it comes to people who aren't necessarily quarantined, people who are frontline workers, healthcare workers and other frontline workers? You spoke with my colleague Maddie earlier this year. I think it was back in May. It was before we saw numbers like we're seeing regularly right now. And you spoke then about the need to take care of those frontline workers. What is the effect on these people of being at this sort of elevated state day in and day out?
Sure. I mean, the frontline workers are experiencing something, I would say, quite a bit different than the quarantine fatigue. Of course, they're experiencing that as well, because when they go home, their loved ones and friends are quarantining, and therefore they are deprived from their company as well. But what they're experiencing is a whole other level of stress, and that is the stress of these overwhelming numbers of people getting sick and dying. If you look at the frontline workers, respiratory therapists, nurses, et cetera, they might get a code every few days, in the worst case. But now, under these kind of conditions, you might see a code several times in a shift, people dying several times in a shift. And there's this sense of helplessness, because even though, you can use the best, most advanced treatments for them, frequently they don't survive the code. And one of the things that's really been very difficult for the frontline workers is what we would call moral injury. Mm. For clear health reasons, people who are acutely ill in hospital beds need to be separated from their family members, even at the moment of death. And what the hospital workers are doing essentially is, keeping these people apart from their family members, even though it's absolutely necessary from a health standpoint. From a moral standpoint, it's very difficult for them. And this leads to feelings of guilt, and all of these stressors together, they lead to depression, anxiety, insomnia, difficulty concentrating, so on and so forth. a slightly similar kind of syndrome to what you'd see with PTSD. So it's really very difficult for these frontline workers. So we've been very invested in providing services to them, including individual counseling as well.
Right. Well, Doctor, I want to end with hopefully on a positive note here. What can we do to take care of ourselves and each other as this continues?
Yeah, that's a very important, very critical step in really getting through this. There are a number of things. You know, we can be more active physically. That's really important. Even, 20 minutes walking, jogging, hiking, even though it is getting a little bit colder now, there are some nice days and we can go out and experience some fresh air and some exertion, which is really very important. Mealtime is very important to have in terms of regularity and to, avoid sort of, junk foods and things like that. Stick to healthy meals. And even if you have to set an alarm or something to make sure you eat at the right time, that can be, very helpful. One of the things that we're doing a lot nowadays is really overdosing on screens. But unfortunately, there are a number of side effects of that. And one of those is that, it's very difficult to sleep. It does promote wakefulness to be, on these screens with the blue light, et cetera. We can do other things. We can read books. We can try muscle relaxation, including stretching. We can, do meditation, including mindfulness meditation, et cetera. And also, very importantly, is, reaching out to other people and investing in family time. Now, even though it might be in Zoom, there's the take five rule, so to speak. You can reach out to five people every day, even for 5 minutes. That can be very beneficial.
Some great tips to leave us with. Dr. Ayman Fanous, thanks so much for your time and for joining us on Quick Take today.
The biggest stories, the moment they happen from around the globe. Subscribe to Bloomberg Quick Take now for insight in an instant.